So here's another example of something that we're going to do with proof by induction. And this is one of those where sometimes you have to think on top of actually doing algebra, because sometimes with proof by induction, you get kind of lucky. You just kind of zone out and do algebra and you get an answer. This one's going to take a little bit, oops, this one's going to take a little bit more love and devotion to get it to work. All right, but it still kind of starts off the same. I'm going to start off, however, by rewriting it as a summation, just to make it a little bit easier to manipulate. All right, so that means that I'm gonna take this, and I can see that this is increasing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to n. So I'm gonna use, for the bottom, I'm gonna put this as I. So it's gonna be I squared, and I is gonna start at 1, and it's gonna go all the way to n. So I'm saying that that has to be less than or equal to 1 over 2 minus 1 over n. Now, it does give us our base case, which is our first step, is you want to demonstrate or show for base case. And in our case, base case is n is equal to 1, because that's the first place that it starts. So that means that everywhere I see an n, I'm going to write a 1. So 1 over I squared. And I want to know, is that less than or equal to 1 minus, or 2 minus 1 over n? So I've got everywhere I see an I, I'm going to put a 1. Is that less than or equal to 2 minus 1? And indeed, 1 is less than or equal to 1. So, good. Done. Proof of the base case. Okay. The next thing is going to assume true for k is equal to 1. Or for some k. How about that? That's what I meant to say. Assume it's true for some k. All right, so that would mean, again, I'm going to take what I originally had. I is going from 1, and instead of saying n, I'm going to call it k. 1 over I squared, I'm going to assume that this is true. All right, now my goal is to show that it's true also for some k plus 1. So my goal is everywhere now that I see a k, I'm going to have it be k plus 1, and I want that to be true. All right, so that's my goal. Now when I'm starting off with my goal, we can kind of do what we've done in the past, which is to get it started and to perturb the sum. So I'm going to start with the same thing on the left. Now what I've got to pay attention to are my inequalities. So I can either use equal signs, or I can use less than or equal signs. And as long as I keep using those, that's okay. But I never want to do something like that, because then I'll mess it up. Because if this is less than this, then everything needs to keep being less than, less than, less than, less than, until I get to the final problem or the final answer. So again, I'm going to perturb the sum. I'm going to take off that k plus 1 term, because that's just something that's pretty straightforward and pretty easy to do. So on the bottom, it's still going to be k plus 1 squared. So that's the k plus 1 term right there. Okay? Now, whenever I plug in my substitution, again, this is my assumption up here includes a less than or equal sign, less than or equal to sign. So that means whenever I come here, I need to make sure that this here has to be a less than or equal to, because those aren't equal. This is specifically less than or equal to that. Okay, so I just need to make sure that I'm consistent with what's going on here. Okay, so I'm probably, let's see, looking at my goal is to have the 2 out front, so I'm going to leave the 2 that I have right here out front, but I'm going to go ahead and combine. I'm going to make these equal now, so that's my first less than or equal sign. Now everything else is going to be equal for a while. I'm going to go ahead and kind of put the k plus 1 squared here, the k plus 1 squared here, and then the k here, and the k here. So I've got k plus 1 squared plus k. Ooh, hold on. Whenever I combine these, let's make sure I've got it right. So let me actually do it this way. I'm going to make this a positive, and I'm just going to go ahead and write this all out. K squared minus 2k minus 1. That way I don't run into any problems when I add that k. I don't have the negative sign kind of fighting me in the back. So k plus 1 squared. Okay, now this is still going to be equal. And I've got a negative k, negative k squared minus a regular k minus 1 over k times k plus 1 squared. Now, I'm going to, and this is the part where you've kind of got to do some thinking. Because we have this less than or equal to thing going on. So my goal is, again, to come over here and have this last term just be k plus 1. Now, it already says, I already have a k plus 1 squared on the bottom, but I've got an extra k and an extra k plus 1 on the bottom. Now, if I look at the top, and this is, again, one of those things that you just kind of have a splash or a flash of inspiration. This is almost k squared plus k, right? With the minus signs and all that kind of stuff, which is cool because that's the same thing as k times k plus 1. So if that was just k squared plus k, then I could do some canceling out and I'd have exactly what I wanted, okay? So we want to keep that in mind. So what we can do is I can say, all right, so if I had something like, let's pretend that this here, let me change my colors. Let's pretend that this here was equal to 8. Okay, so right now, let's pretend that just says 8 minus 1. So 8 minus 1 is always going to be less than or equal to 8. And you're like, well, it's all negatives. I'm like, okay, well, let's call it negative 8 minus 1. Well, that's still going to be less than or equal to negative 8. So the idea is that I can actually take this last term and I can get rid of it as long as I don't make them equalities, but instead I make it a less than or equal to. So I can say, well, that's going to be less than or equal to whatever this is without the negative 1. Well, without the negative 1 is more, I guess is the way to say it. If I don't subtract off 1, I get more. So I can put in this less than or equal sign, less than or equal to sign, and just drop that negative 1 off of there. Now I can go back to equalities again, minus k squared plus k, k plus 1 squared. Again, 2 minus k times k plus 1. Over k plus 1 squared. So the k plus 1 cancels out with the square, the k and the k go away, and then I'm ending up with 2 minus 1 over k plus 1. And actually, that is exactly what I was looking for. So what we had to do here that was particularly clever is we have this silly less than or equal to thing. So as I go through here, all of these either have to be equal to's or less than or equal to. If I flip the sign, then it doesn't work anymore. And the thing that we had to do that was kind of clever is the step from here to here. So that was kind of like the clever part so that we could keep that less than or equal to kind of thing going and end up with the proof that we were looking for.